Hi, I'm Erin Fehlau. Thanks for joining us here on the web. We're expecting heavy rain and high winds tonight. And for more on that, you can check out the weather section of this website. In other news, Northfield police are searching for two men who attacked a woman as she was walking at the Northfield Village Apartments on Spring Street. The victim told police that two people she didn't recognize threw her to the ground and beat her. Ray Brewer reports.
She had knocked on the door, and she had cuts on her face and on her arms, and I immediately called 911.
It was about 7:40 Monday evening when Isla Carter's neighbor showed up. Carter says her neighbor told her she was taking some trash out to the dumpster when she was jumped by two people, but she didn't have much in the way of specifics.
She couldn't tell you exactly what they look like, but she said one was short, but she believed that it was two people.
And all of a sudden, the ambulance came. And then all of a sudden, one of the guys came over and said, "Did you see anything?"
Julie Landry said she'd been playing cards and gossiping in a nearby gazebo and didn't notice anyone lurking around. Whoever was responsible for the assault remains at large.
We searched the area with a K-9, couldn't find anybody, had numerous officers searching from around towns around us, but up to now we still have nothing.
The victim had recently been involved in a domestic situation, and court records show a man was arrested earlier this month for threatening her. But police say the woman told them the attack had nothing to do with that. Police say one of the things they're trying to figure out is why the victim didn't use the dumpster at her apartment complex and instead walked down the road to use the dumpster at another complex. Police also say this was definitely a targeted attack based on what one of the attackers said to the victim. And Julie Landry, at least, isn't concerned for her safety.
We'll have much more on this case for you starting on News 9 at 5. Well, it was a slow commute for drivers on Route 101 this morning. State police say a truck took down some power lines off Exit 1, causing a backup on both the exit and the highway. Power crews were called in to put the lines back up, and things eventually returned to normal. In Commitment 2012 news, Republican vice presidential nominee Paul Ryan just wrapped up a rally in Dover. Before taking questions from the crowd, he talked about the national debt and how our share has grown from $35,000 4 years ago to $51,000 per person today. He says debt is getting out of control. Every man,
woman, and the most predictable economic crisis we have ever had in this country is this debt crisis that is on our horizon. We have a moral obligation to lead and do something about this. That's why I'll just say it is an honor to join this ticket, because I am excited we finally have a chance of getting this country back on the right track by reclaiming our founding principles and getting Americans back to work.
We are going to be sitting down with Mr. Ryan for a one-on-one interview, and we're going to share what he had to say on News 9 starting at 6. On Friday, Vice President Joe Biden and his wife Jill are returning to the Granite State. They're going to be attending a grassroots event at the State House in Concord at 3:30. Tickets are required, and you can find information on how to get those on our website, WMUR.com. The Bidens are also expected to attend events on Saturday. Also ahead at 5 this evening, police say a thief made off with a standout item, a 1955 antique tow truck. It was stolen from the fenced-in yard of a local business. How police think someone managed to make off with it, and the custom features that would make it difficult for just anyone to steal. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us, and have a great afternoon.